And hello everyone, my name is Lena. In fact, the big competition season after the World Championships has ended, and by the end of the year we have time to sum up not only this year, but also the whole Olympic cycle. Many people are asking for a video of the new rules. It will definitely be, and I think not the only one, a video from the Olympics is also in progress, so don't worry, I will do everything as I promise, as soon as I have free time and the speed of creating these videos. Well, today we'll talk about the FIG conference, where there was an election of people who will be dealing with the management and technical issues for the next Olympic cycle. We will also talk about the events that await us this year and discuss other news from the world of gymnastics. So let's probably start with the most discussed topic of the week, the elections of the International Gymnastics Federation. This year, from November 5th to 7th, the 83rd Congress was held in Antalya, Turkey, in which all the gymnastics Federation of the countries took part. At the moment, there are 156 of them, taking into account the fact that this year the list was supplemented by 7 more countries that opened gymnastics federations. Within the framework of the Congress, several amendments to the Charter were adopted, mainly related to the elimination of the procedural trifles, such as the decision to leave only one language as the official language of the Federation. I think you can guess that it is English. An electronic training program is also starting to work. Because of it, sports officials will be able to improve their qualification and sharing knowledge will be much easier. Also, this platform will work for judges who will be able to take theoretical exams online. Materials on all gymnastics disciplines from various experts will be collected on this platform. The presidents of technical committees, including rhythmic gymnastics, Natalia Kuzminauer, also awarded with the badge of distinctions for many years of work in gymnastics federation. They also became honorary vice presidents of the organization, and as I understood, Natalia Kuzminauer remained working in gymnastics federation. Well, the most interesting thing is of course the re-election. So Morinari Watanabe from Japan became the president of the International Gymnastics Federation again. He quite decently overtook his competitor in the first round and was re-elected to the post without a second vote. Kim Nelly from Belarus, Ali Al-Hitmi from Qatar, Suat Selen from Turkey became vice presidents. Vasily Titov from Russia, who held this position, also ran, but unfortunately he didn't get enough votes and he took an ordinary position in the executive committee. In the interview after the election, he said that this happened due to the scandal with Kuzmina, and the FIG withdrew her from the election, so this affected the federation and the voting for Russia. Let's move on to the rhythmic gymnastics only. So firstly, the most scandalous position of the president of technical committee. It was won by Noha Abu Shaban from Egypt, although she had no competition. If you remember, after the Olympic Games, a scandal began with Natalia Kuzminova from Russia, who held this position and still hold it until the end of this year. Until I forget, everyone will start their post from the 1st of January 2022. So Irina Viner accused Natalia Kuzminova of unfair judging at the Tokyo Olympics. In the interview, she said that it was all her fault, and also that it is better to have no one than such a person. In this regard, Irina Viner influenced the fact that VFAG recalled Natalia Kuzminova from the post of the president of the technical committee. Later, Natalia filed an ethical court and she was reinstated in the election application before the proceedings. However, without the support of the NATO Federation, Natalia Kuzminova would not have anything, so FIG made a decision and removed Natalia from the election. As for me, they just found someone to blame all their anger on, and it's hard to say whether Russia will be better off without its own person in the gymnastics federation. After all, now if suddenly something goes wrong, then there will be no one to blame. Well, on the contrast, they will blame the fact that there are no Russian delegates in the federation. In general, the situation is not pleasant in any case, and I'm insanely sorry for Natalia here. As for me, she has nothing to do with it. What is the point of doing badly with my own? This logic is incomprehensible to me. Write in the comments what you think about it and in general about the whole situation with the scandal with Natalia Kuzmina. In the meantime, Noha Abu Shaban will be in charge of the technical part. At the age of 28, she joined the FIG, becoming the youngest woman in the federation. Later, she became vice president. In fact, she was the second person after Natalia Kuzmina. However, her name didn't come up during the scandal at the Olympics for some reason. Although, if Kuzmina is accused, then probably Noha was aware of everything. So, Noha has been doing gymnastics since she was 7 years old in her country and participated in international and African championships. Then she worked in banking sector, and as a hobby she was engaged in activities in FIG. But in 2008 she won the election and fully engaged in work in FIG. The most interesting thing is that back in 2013, with Natalia Kuzmina and Noha Abushaban, there was a scandal in the world of gymnastics. At that moment, the International Federation and Technical Committee of Rhythmic Gymnastics were opposed to each other. The proceedings were held in the sports court. At that time, the leadership of the FIG accused the members of the technical committee in fraud of passing special exams for right to judge international competition. So more than 15 judges were suspended, as well as members of technical committee. Among them was Natalia Kuzmina, Noha Abushaban, Maria Gigova from Bulgaria, and there were other suspended members of the technical committee. As a result, everyone was acquitted. However, Bruna Brandy, the president of the federation at that time, was very dissatisfied with this. The news then wrote that Kuzmina was being tried to be suspended because she was Russian, in order to harm the Russian Gymnastics Federation. In this way, and again this phrase, that the hegemony of Russian rhythmic gymnastics on the world stage is violated, it looks familiar. Then Natalia Kuzmina herself said in an interview that these are political games. In general, everything is difficult, even in the politics of rhythmic gymnastics, and clearly something is going on there. And there are underhand games, but those whose sides they are actually defending, we probably won't find out. And of course, I want to believe that all is just a speculation and everything is fair and honest everywhere. The election also included the election of the members of technical committee. So they are Isabel Saveit from Germany. She was re-elected. For new term, Natalia Bulanova from Azerbaijan again took up this post. Maria Petrova from Bulgaria, Marcia Lauren from Brazil, Maria Moltebach from Norway, and Lyubov Cherkashina from Belarus also took up these positions again. So we can say that the committee has been almost completely updated, with the exception of one person. The next contest will be held in October 2022 in Norway. Meanwhile, the Russian national team went to Dubai after the World Championship, where they spent a vacation. Not only the participants of the Olympic Games and the World Championships came here, but also other teams. Dina and Arina haven't yet specifically talked about the competition or continuation of their careers. Anastasia Salas and Alina Harnaska also rested after the World Championship, and the Cup of Russia, which was supposed to take place from November 3rd to 7th in Moscow, was cancelled due to coronavirus. There are no dates at the moment, so I think everything will depend on the situation in the country. But on November 13th, Spain will host competition where our Russian gymnast will perform. So in Barcelona, the Catalan Gymnastics Federation is organizing the 6th international tournament. At the moment, Dara Chupnikova and Lala Kamarenka from Russia, Polina Karika and Nicole Krasiuk from Ukraine, Yana Striga from Belarus, and Alexandra Ajajkuleza from Italy have been announced for the tournament. There are no lists yet, so perhaps we will see other stars. On November 20th, an equally wonderful event will take place in Spain. The traditional Escola Gym show will feature world gymnastics stars, including Lina Ashram, Olympic champion, Alexandra Soldatova, public favorite and world champion, Yekaterina Selezneva, Alina Harnaska, Yekaterina Halkina, and other equally cool gymnasts. And judging by Sasha Soldatova's Instagram, she and the Art Bless company are suing something new for the performance. The Bulgarian national team of individual gymnasts held training camps at the Belmikan base. So this is the national base where many Bulgarian athletes conduct training camps. From there, there are 4 atmospheric training photos and a fascinating video from Stylyana Nikolova. Well, for true fans of gymnastics who have watched till the end, I will share personal news from the world of gymnastics. I think many people remember the amazing gymnast Paulina Szmatkowa, who had to end her career due to health problems. She definitely remained in our memories as the most emotional gymnast. Just a few days ago, information appeared in the media about the death of her father. He was the ex-minister of energy of Russia and helped Rhythmic Gymnastics Federation. The cause of his death is coronavirus. I love this gymnast so much, so from the bottom of my heart, I want to send her kindness and warmth at such a difficult moment. Well, that's all for today, and remember that I love you all very much, and bye bye.